Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Hope you are well by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome to NIEBS Homeschool. This is Fatima Sabrin Shikha, Assistant Teacher of National Ideal English Version School, Morning Shift. Today I'm going to take home science class for the students of class 7 on the topic of chapter 11, Summary. Students, I'm repeating, today our topic is chapter 11, Summary. Today our lecture number is 11 and homework number is also 11. I'm repeating, our lecture number is 11 and homework number is also 11. Students, take your home science book and open chapter 11. We'll learn the summary of this chapter. So let's begin. Chapter 11, name, preservation of food. We have to preserve food in a scientific way so that they remain original for a long time and we can use them in future. This is the main purpose behind preservation. So why we preserve food? We'll preserve our food in a scientific way because we want to use these foods in future. Students, now we'll discuss about lesson 1, necessity of preservation of food. People use, okay, lesson 1, necessity of preservation of food, and now I'm going to elaborately discuss on this. People used to preserve only crops as it is main food. With the technological development of fridge, cold store, nowadays importance is also given to preserve fruits, vegetables, fish, meat, etc. Students, we know from the previous time, we usually use our crops. That means rice, lentils, or other crops. But with the development of technology, we used to preserve fruits, vegetables, fish, meat. This type of foods. Now we'll learn food that are suitable to preserve. Grain type food, vegetables, fruits, and food made of vegetables and fruits. Fish, meat, and food made of fish and meat. Milk and milk products. So these are the food that are suitable to preserve. We can easily preserve this type of foods. Now we'll learn importance of food preservation. Now we'll learn importance of food preservation. Students, open page number 121. Okay, look here, page number 121, importance of food preservation. Students, please read these points carefully at home. This is very important. Through this, you can learn why we need to preserve our food. And this is important for creative question answer. Now we'll discuss about lesson 2. Name, classification of food according to their decaying or perishable nature. Now, perishable means decaying. Food that are suitable to preserve can be divided into three classes according to their decaying nature. And we can divide these foods into three: perishable food, less perishable food, imperishable food. Say with me, perishable food, less perishable food, and imperishable food. Now we'll discuss about three types of food. Okay, first, perishable food are the food that perish easily. There are some foods which perish quickly within 24 hours and contain more water are known as perishable food. So if I ask you the question, what is perishable food, you can easily answer the foods that perish quickly within 24 hours and contain more water are called perishable food. For example, you can say fish, meat, milk, tomato, vegetables, etc. We can preserve them by boiling, refrigerating, and with ice. It means through this way we can preserve perishable food. We can preserve fish, meat, milk, this type of foods. Now we'll learn less perishable food. Foods that remain original for some days and contain less water than the perishable food are called less perishable food. So the question arises, what is less perishable food? Food that contains less water than perishable food and that remain original for some days are called less perishable food. And for example, we can say pumpkin, sweet pumpkin, arum, potatoes, etc. And some fruits, guava, olive, palm. So these are called less perishable food. Now we'll learn about imperishable food. Foods that contain almost no water are called imperishable food. Students, imperishable and in less perishable, we know that food contains water. It means more water is called perishable food and less water than perishable food is less perishable food. And the food which almost contains no water are called imperishable food. And for example, rice, lentils, wheat, dried chili, turmeric, etc. These foods contain almost no water. Because have you seen water in rice, lentil, wheat or dried chili? Okay, we can easily preserve this by drying under the sun. Now it's time to discuss about lesson 3, name reasons for decaying of food. It means why foods are decaying. We learn about these reasons. We have to know the reasons of decaying of food so that we can preserve food. Foods become contaminated and rotten when microorganisms, notable microbes are bacteria, yeast and fungus. So if I ask you, can you mention some notable microbes? You can answer bacteria, yeast, fungus. These are responsible for the decaying of food. And also enzymes, chemical reactions and unsuitable place to preserve food are equally responsible for decaying food. So not only bacteria, yeast and fungus, we find enzymes, chemical reactions and unsuitable place to preserve food are also responsible for decaying food. Now lesson 4, ways of food preservation at home. So how can we preserve our foods, that different kinds of food at our home? Now we'll learn the ways. All the food that we get from nature are perishable. Whether it can be perishable, less perishable and imperishable, but it's not perfect. We can preserve food by maintaining some ways. Main purposes to preserve food at home. Why we preserve our food? Is there any purpose? Yes, we have some purpose, and this purpose are taking food of one season in another season. So if we take or if we find mango in this season, we can preserve for another season. Like this, we can preserve almost all kinds of foods for another season. Next, preventing food from wasting. If we preserve our food, we can save our food from wasting. And we can use it later. Preventing the actions of germs and enzymes in food. So we can prevent the actions of germs and enzymes in food. Keeping food nutritious and fulfill the demand of food. So these are the purpose to preserve food at home. Now some general ways to preserve food at home. We can preserve food by drying them in sunlight, using molasses or sugar, using vinegar and oil, using salt, using ice. So by following this, we can easily preserve our food at home. Say with me again, by drying them, that means by drying the foods in sunlight, using molasses or sugar, using vinegar and oil, using salt, using ice. We can easily preserve our food. Students, I hope you have understood the summary of this chapter. Please read the text again and again at home. I have given you homework. Do 10 MCQ from chapter 11. And please write only answer. No need to make any option. Write the question and give the answer. Don't forget to write the lecture number and homework number with the submission date. Our lecture number is 11 and homework number is also 11. And the submission date will be the date of Sunday, because on every Sunday you have to submit your SW copies. Students, do your homework in your SW copy. You need to be serious, because you will get your CT, diary and SBA marks on the basis of the submission of your SW copies. Guardians or anyone else can submit your SW copies on every Sunday and can collect your previous copies on next Sunday. That's all for today. Hope you have understood today's topic. Keep practicing at home and abide by your parents. Stay well and see you again. Till then, Allah Hafiz. Assalamu alaikum.